Hello everyone, it's the Dutch Sims 4 Master and welcome to this brand new The Sims 4 Speed Build. So today, this one is very exciting because it's all about a new stuff pack for The Sims 4 called Tiny Living. And as the name probably says already, this is a speed build in which I'm building a tiny house. And that's all what this new stuff pack is all about. And I'm honestly really, really excited about this new pack because it comes not only with very many new cool items, which are super useful in tiny homes, but it also comes with a new restriction, or actually a lot type to which a certain restriction is bound, which is the lot, or the amount of tiles which you can build on that lot. You've got three different types. The first one being the micro home with a maximum of 32 tiles. For one home, then you've got the tiny house, which is actually this building, which I'm currently making, which is 64 lots maximum. And then you've got a small house, I believe it's called a small lot. I believe it's small house. And that's got a maximum of 100 tiles on one lot. And that's actually more challenging than you'd expect, because this house I'm building in the end came down to exactly 64 tiles. And I actually had to change a little bit in order to get that done. One of my biggest challenges with this house was actually that it's two stories, meaning you need stairs in order to have the Sims get up. And stairs take up quite some space, especially when you've got an like sort of inconvenient shape like I've got going here. But anyways, it was a lot of fun, and therefore I'm really excited about this stuff pack, because it really comes with a new challenge to build mode, which is cool. And it's like a stuff pack, so it's only 10 bucks. It's coming out tomorrow on Tuesday, the 21st of January. And yeah, I'm very excited for you all to check it out. Thank you, EA, for letting me play it early in order to show you guys what this pack is all about. And throughout this speed build, you'll definitely see very many of the new items that come with the pack. And I was really surprised by how many items there are. I must say, this is obviously really a pack for builders. I'm not even sure if there's anything in Create a Sim available in this new pack, but I do know that yeah, for build mode there's a lot. There's like new chairs, new tables, really cool new bar stools, and like a high table, which is really cool, which you'll see me use in this pack as well, or in this speed build. Then you've also got some cool decorative items, a new painting. And one of the main features of the new pack is a bed, which can actually be, yeah, sort of locked up into some cabinet, or you can turn it into a sofa, so sort of a changeable bed sofa combination, or cupboard sofa combination, meaning that it's really convenient to use, and does not take up too much space, because in the day you can use it as a sofa, and then during the night when you want your Sims to sleep, they can actually turn it into a bed. And that actually makes that this tiny house can house up to four people. I must say, it will get kind of crowded also, because like the kitchen is not that large, because like I said, this is a small tiny house. But nevertheless, it's really cool to just really challenge yourself. And I must say, I was challenged to get started with this, because I try to create like special buildings, and often that leaves you with some crazy things which look cool but actually take up very many tiles, because all those like design aspects always take up tiles. But now I really had to like really restrict myself, and at some point I was almost going to a small lot already, which means a maximum of 100 tiles. You can actually see that limitation on the top of the screen, but then I realized that that was actually just too much. I realized that 100 tiles would make it too easy for me, and I really wanted to be bound to the challenge. So I decided to cut it down onto 64 tiles, and in the end it worked out. But yeah, you can download this house from the gallery. It's gallery ID Dutch Sims Master. There you can also download any of my other houses which I upload here on YouTube. And I'm very curious to see what you all create. So if you find a way to share your tiny houses with me, you can do that on like Twitter or Instagram. Please do so, because I'm really interested to see what creative tiny houses people create. I must say, with this one, I've sort of stayed kind of neutral, or at least not too crazy. I still have to create one, in my opinion, in which I'm really going all crazy and come up with very many smart ideas to just stay below that tile limit but still create a cool looking house. In this case, it's still sort of realistic, kind of futuristic maybe, also because of the yellow, but I thought that would sort of add a cool touch I've done a house with those colors before, and for some reason I just like how colorful it is, and it just looks cool and like contemporary, and it just felt like some cool decoration for the garden. Also because the house itself is not that special, I felt like the garden had to be something special on its own, without getting too crazy. I've not added a pool because, I mean, when you live in a tiny house, you want to like decrease your footprint, want to be good for the environment. You also want to, you know, not spend too much money on your house, so then you don't have a pool. I'm sure that I'll ever build a tiny house where I do add a pool as well, but for this first one, I decided it wasn't too much or too good of an idea. Important to note, by the way, is that I've been super busy lately, so therefore I haven't really uploaded that many videos. I'm sorry about that, but I've really been busy with university work and all that kind of stuff. However, with these tiny houses, I've got a little bit more time to actually work, or at least these take slightly less time to create, so that's good. So I'm definitely going to focus more on tiny houses in the future as well, because I think it's really challenging. It's actually a lot of fun to play around with that and trying to make it work. So see me do this more often. However, I'll also continue making like the regular speed builds, obviously. But I've just really been busy, so that sort of sucks. But at least I've got a video out now. And it was a lot of fun to work on it again, especially with new content, of course. Then it's even more fun to work on it, so that's good. By the way, here I'm really struggling with these stairs, and I was like, maybe I should not record it or cut it out, but then I realized it's actually fun for you all maybe to see how I struggled with it, and maybe you can learn something from it. And it also shows that, yeah, this was just a process of me trying to figure out how those new staircases work. And I knew how I wanted it to be, but I wasn't too sure how I could get my stairs to function the way I wanted it to. And then in the end, here it worked. So now I've got the staircase in the corner. I had to extend a little bit on the top of on the second level, in order to make it work. But in the end, the staircase does not take up too much space, and it actually looks really cool because I've made it all glass, and in that way, it's actually become some kind of architectural feature. And also, I really think it's cool how those large windows work so well in this house. I don't use them too often, but I think I should actually use them more often, or at least in this one, it really works out well, because they just sort of work well with that tiny living or tiny housing style. And I've gone for quite a detailed garden just because I felt like that would sort of finish it up. I'm not too sure if I'm actually correctly staying to the limit. Oh yeah, I had to actually decrease the size of the front porch a little bit in order to make it work out, but in the end it did, and we're actually staying within that 64 tile limit, or actually I'm exactly on that 64 tiles, so that's good, because that's the limit for the tiny house. And I definitely will be making a micro house as well, but you know, when something gets so small, it's like so much harder to create something that looks special and innovative and stuff. So I think in order to make that look cool, I'll really go into some kind of crazy innovative stuff, or have to come up with something. For now I just wanted to create like some kind of regular tiny house, which you can, that's just sort of normal. Also just for some kind of inspiration for all of you, so that you know what to build. But for builders, this is definitely the stuff pack to get, because I really like the items. I'm actually getting started with the interior right now, I believe. And there you'll see a very many of the items that are new. I was struggling because all of a sudden I realized, of course, there had to be a kitchen in the place as well. And maybe they should have come up with some kind of solution where you've got an all-in-one kitchen. If I remember correctly, we used to have that in The Sims 3, but I'm not too sure. But something in me says that we used to have some kind of all-in-one kitchen in The Sims 3, where you had everything you need in the kitchen just in one or two squares. Now I managed to, I believe, oh wait, no, okay. And I now realize that I haven't added the sink in the video. However, I will have added it once you download the house from the gallery, because I know that's necessary, of course, but and I know people are very picky with that, so I definitely still got like 100 comments of people saying that they miss the sink and that there's no place to cut their food or just to have a free counter. I believe the free counter is actually a problem, but if that's indeed the case, then you can always remove the microwave because that leaves you with a free counter. And like I said, I'll be adding the sync for when I upload it to the gallery, so don't worry about that. Because I know people can get all crazy about it. Also, something that was hard for me to think about was, because I'm an architecture student, you really think about the details as well and the connections between certain materials, and especially with tiny houses, because you tend to think about the way you actually like connect stuff, and because it's so tiny, you tend to build it yourself as well. You really have to think about the connection between the different materials, but in The Sims that's not really possible because that's just too much into the architecture stuff and not very relevant for many people. But for me, normally if I would in real life design a tiny house, I would definitely look for the details and the cool material connections, and in this case that's not possible. So therefore it really had to come from the shape of the building, which makes it hard, because when you've not got that many tiles to use, coming up with some crazy shape is quite a challenge. What I thought was cool, by the way, was that you can add that bat cupboard combination, bat shelf sofa thing, and you can actually put things in the shelf and behind the glass, and it's just, and you can also separate the two, so you've got that combination, but you can also separate the right shelf from the main thing, as you just saw me do, which is sort of cool, and I really would like to see that happen to more items, and that you can sort of modify the items by themselves. I'm not too sure if you ever played SimCity, but back in the day with SimCity, you had, like, for instance, a fire station, but then you were able to add separate garages or separate towers to those specific lots. So you'd add the lot, and then later on you would be able to customize it. And I'd really like to see that happen to more items in The Sims game itself as well, because in that way you'd be able to slightly customize the items you're adding to the house, and that way it would be, like, more multifunctional, I guess. And as you can see up here, we've got the bedroom with an ensuite bathroom, where I didn't add a door because, you know, it's small, and I thought, you know, it's sort of cool to have it immediately connected. Also, this solved kind of a problem with the window being in the middle of it, so in the end it just looked better, and it worked out better, so I decided not to add a just a door. That's the word I was looking for. And I'm adding very many of the same paintings, just because I wanted that to be some kind of theme that would be coming back. And here I'm creating that cool staircase with all the glass around it. And honestly, I think it's really cool how you can actually see up into the house, and you can see that staircase, which is changing direction, obviously, which I'm realizing now how happy I am with that. I'm not too sure actually if I've used that before in houses, because that update was actually quite a long time ago, but I haven't really used it yet. But it's really useful, and it really gives you many more opportunities to add staircases to houses, and especially when you're working on a small house like this one, that's really necessary. And then now the bathroom is finished up as well, adding some last painting there. And then I think it really has some kind of the feel of a tiny house as well, because I used all of those items coming with the pack, and those items are actually really like tiny house themed, because they're sort of like IKEA stuff, but then slightly more designish. I feel like it's a little bit more special, but also slightly more, just very focused on convenience as well. Just cool. And then here I'm finishing up the garden, because like I said, the garden is sort of important. If the house itself is not too big or too special on its own. So I added like 4 laying beds, because, you know, if they find it too tiny to live inside, maybe they can sleep outside under the stars and still enjoy their home. And just adding very many plants, because I just felt like landscaping it all a bit. Like I mentioned, you can download it from the gallery. You've got to look for Urgent ID Dutch Sims Master. And if you do so, you can also follow me there to see it whenever I upload new houses. And also don't forget that you can follow me here on YouTube, so that you see it whenever I upload a new video. I'll definitely be uploading more tiny houses, maybe next weekend already. which I'm really excited about because I think these tiny houses are a lot of fun to create. And I'm also, this upcoming week, going to think about some ideas of how to actually create some innovative tiny house already, because this one is, it looks cool, I think. And personally, if I would be able to live in a tiny house like this, I would definitely do so. And it's sort of designish in my opinion, but it's not too crazy and nothing too detailed. It's very contemporary. But the idea is also that this could maybe be copied and maybe would be some kind of holiday homes, which would be placed on such a park, you know, where you've got very many of these homes all around a park with a like communal pool or whatever in a beautiful surrounding. But yeah, for the next one, I'll think of something different. For now, let me know in the comments what you think of this build, and also if you've got any ideas for the next build, and also if there's anything else besides a tiny house that you would like to see, because I've got quite some ideas in my mind for a new speed build. I just need to find the time to create them, but I will be back with many videos, don't worry about that. Here I'm adding that fireplace. I added those yellow poofs, but I realized that they didn't really match up nicely with the other yellow color, so I decided to actually remove those from the scene and just go with white and black, which worked out perfectly in the end. But anyways, thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. Like I mentioned, don't forget to subscribe and like the video if you enjoyed it, and then I hope to see you back in another video very soon. Goodbye.